guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Reading Bear and I hope you are ready for some more stories. And today, we will take a look at some new Pori Ranch content.
If you enjoyed my content, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and post some bear emojis in the comment. And now, let's dive right into the stories.
First one is titled, One Ball Lighter. I am from South Africa, just for context. This incident takes place 3 years ago. Some background. I worked in middle management at an IT consulting company that provided managed services to a petrochemical giant that is headquartered in South Africa but had sites all over Europe, Asia and North America. I was a project portfolio manager responsible for multiple project managers who were based at each site. We handled large IT projects and had very strict SLAs to comply with. Delayed projects resulted in a financial penalty which would directly affect our performance ratings. I reported to the account manager who was only hired because she was a relative of the VP. The account manager would spend most of her days having coffee meetings with upper management. All middle management involved with this client reported to the VP and she was the type of boss who enjoyed hearing the sound of her own voice and turned every conversation and meeting about herself. We have regular review meetings with the client and their international counterparts to discuss each department's performance. The meeting would be held at the client's South African offices in the late afternoons and members of the America, Europe and Asia team would join via Zoom. The meeting rooms were very plush and had two very large monitors, one for presented content and the other for viewing the remote speaker's camera. One day ahead of each review meeting, our team has our own internal prep meeting. This was so that we could all review our team's updates and give the VP a heads up on what to expect. She would then use those updates to show off to our executives how well she was performing. The incident. One weekend I notice a slight lump on my testicle. It feels odd and I decide to have it checked out. I go to my doctor and after a few minutes of squishy and him taking a small injection sample, he gives me some medication to manage the swelling and tells me to return in a week. He tells me not to panic and is most probably nothing to worry about. There is no pain so I don't take any time off from work but I do send a message to my team to prepare them to self-manage in the event that it turns out to be serious. I send a heads up to my manager that I would need to take some sick leave soon and will share the schedule with her after my consult with the doctor. I go and see my doctor. He does a bit more squishy and checks his notes. He then tells me that the lump has grown much bigger and I need to have emergency surgery and was admitted the next day. I send an update to everyone and finalize a few tasks. That evening I prepare my slide deck with the necessary updates, ensuring I add in additional detail so that my updates would be self-explanatory and ask one of my senior project managers to join the meeting on my behalf. On the day of my admission, I send a message to my manager that I was taking sick leave due to an emergency and to contact my senior project manager if they needed anything from my department. I then go off to the hospital and my surgery was scheduled for the next morning. The manager did not bother to read my email. One of the team members who ran the prep meeting noticed I was not in the Zoom call. He decided instead of asking if anyone knew where I was to rather report me to the VP. Strike 1. The VP tries to call me and for obvious reasons I miss her call. She proceeds to email me the threat of a first written warning. Strike 2. Since I have not responded to her email or any of her calls, she proceeds with emailing me a second written warning. This was all in the space of a few hours on the same day. My surgery resulted in one of my testicles being removed. When I awoke, I was told that I was now one ball lighter. But the surgery was an overall success and to just get some rest. Later on that day I grab my phone out of my bag and see the missed calls and messages. I reply to the VP that I apologize for missing the prep meeting but I was unfortunately on sick leave due to an emergency and had nominated a senior manager to stand in on my behalf. Strike 3. She throws a tantrum and starts to hurl a barrage of messages towards me. How only she can approve leave and I obviously didn't submit it to her in advance. She then threatens me with a final written warning if I am not present at the review meeting. Revenge. I join the meeting on Zoom but keep my camera off, This is not uncommon, and go on mute. A few minutes after the meeting starts, the VP fires off her final treat to me because I'm not there in person. I wait through the meeting till it's time for me to present my slide deck and then go off mute and turn on my camera. Everyone in the meeting could hear me grate them, and those that looked at the screen was mortified to see me in a hospital bed. The VP has her head buried deep into her laptop screen and has not yet seen me. Our client stops me immediately and asks me what is going on. I tell them that I am here to provide my updates and then proceed to read the information on slide 1 as if nothing happened. The client stops the meeting again and turns to the VP asking her why I was on the call when I should obviously be on leave, and the VP responds that she did not approve any leave and expects her team to always be there for client meetings. The client tells the VP to look at the monitor and she finally sees me in a hospital bed. She then decided to double down on her belief and tells the client how I was being insubordinate and disrupting her meeting and that I should proceed with my updates because we are all waiting. The client immediately calls for the meeting to be adjourned and tells me to drop off the call. She then tells the VP that she is raising the VP's actions as a security risk and revokes her access to the building pending an executive review. The unexpected double kill. The next morning, while waiting to be discharged, I get a call from the GM. He was irate and belligerent. The VP has told him that it was due to my insubordination that her access was revoked, but failed to tell him exactly what happened. After I let him rant for a few minutes, I asked him if he knew where I was, and he replied that unless I was at the office immediately, I would be dismissed and personally charged. I respond that I will be there in the hour. I decided to go for gold and went straight to the office in my hospital gown and proceed to do the shameless walk into the office straight to the executive suite. I was stopped by the CEO and questioned on why I would come to the office in this state, and I told him of the GM's remarks. The GM was called into the office and just froze when he saw me. I then asked one of the other nicer team members to describe the previous day's events, and they explained the VP's actions. I was told to leave immediately and go home and rest. The fallout. I send the CEO and HR screenshots of all of the VP's messages, emails, and also got it to provide me with the recording from the phone system of the GM's call. The GM and VP were fired immediately, and I was offered a settlement for my pain and suffering. Next one is titled, Revenge on a Police Officer. Title sounds far worse than it actually is. I was turning out of a shopping center one day and passed a school. Didn't see any buses or children around. The school zone sign was not visible from where I was turning from. Got up to normal speed for the road and pass a cop parked in the neighborhood across the street. Lights go on. I'm the only one on the road, so I know it's me and pull over. At this point, I've passed the school zone sign on the other side of the road and I can see it's on. He comes over, tells me I was speeding in a school zone, and gives me a ticket. I explain that I couldn't see the zone sign being on. He tells me that it should have been fixed but wasn't, so he likes to sit there and give out tickets to people turning from the shopping center. I waited until I got home. Called every county number for roads and schools that I could find. All told me it needed to come from the Board of Supervisors, they knew it should have been fixed, and that their hands were tied. So I emailed the County Board of Supervisors, explained how I was pulled over and there wasn't a flashing sign on the side next to the shopping center. Stated how this was a safety concern to students, parents, teachers, bus drivers, and that it should be corrected. They knew of the issue and had a new light added to the back of the sign. I did pay my fine, never went to court as I was clearly guilty. But now I smile whenever I drive past that school zone and the new light is on, because I know that that smug officer can't effectively trap people there for not seeing a broken sign. Next one is titled, Post Office Said I Couldn't File a Complaint About the Mailman Not Trying to Deliver My Packages Because I Had No Proof, So I Got Proof. For context, in my country, if your package gets sent through the National Post Service, you're basically screwed. It takes 200 years and they never actually deliver it. I don't know how it is in other countries, but here they are supposed to ring the doorbell if the package doesn't fit the mailbox, and if you don't answer they leave a notice and you have to go and pick it up all the way at the post office. The problem is that my mailman doesn't even try to deliver them. He just leaves the notice without even ringing the doorbell and leaves. I've had to pick up nearly every package I've ordered because of that. Well, the last time was my last straw. I was obviously home because of the pandemic. Suddenly I received a call that immediately hung up, and it was so fast that my phone didn't even ring, just showed up as a missed call. No doorbell, nothing. I suspected it was the mailman and ran to the door only to find him inside the truck, looking straight at me before driving off. Well, I was upset and called the post office to file a complaint. I explained the situation and the lady told me that I couldn't file a complaint because they are only instructed to ring the doorbell and calling is optional and I couldn't prove that he didn't ring it. At first I just avoided using them again at all costs, but the other day I ordered something and chose a delivery company from the ones listed on the website. Apparently that company hires the National Post Service to deliver for them here. When I found out, I basically stalked the tracking info for days. It was about 2 weeks late, until one day late at night it said it had arrived my country, which usually means that the next day it's going to be delivered. The next day, I woke up at 7 a.m. to check. My suspicions were correct, it said, out for delivery. I quickly grabbed something to eat, got in my car and parked right outside my house. Then I waited, and waited, and waited, 6 hours in total until I finally see the post truck pulling over. I grabbed my phone to record and watched as the mailman opened the door already either the notice in hand, slid it inside my mailbox and turned around. I got out of the car and said, "Excuse me, what are you doing?" He didn't even look at me and said, "Just delivering packages, miss." Then I stood there as that asshole grabbed his phone to call me and quickly hung up. I smiled as I took my phone out of my pocket and sarcastically stated, "Oh bummer, you didn't even give time to reach for the phone." He literally turned white, couldn't even speak. I continued, "Now can you give me my package please?" He quickly opened the truck, almost tripped and took out my package. "See, wasn't that easier than your whole scheme?" He finally manages to say, "Sorry miss." I turned around and left. He probably thought he got lucky I didn't say anything else, but little did he know that I sent the video to the post office via email attached to my complaint. Well, let's just say I have a new mailman. This one tries to leave 1 second after ringing the doorbell, but at least he rings. Edit. For everyone commenting about paragraphs, I'm sorry, I wrote this on my phone and it kept deleting. This was my 5th time writing the whole text. Give me a break. Edit 1. Everyone saying I should just install a camera. That would work, yes, but then he would leave with the package and I would have to go pick it up. I wanted my package that day. Edit 2. For everyone saying I got him fired and that's not something to brag about. Firstly, as much as it isn't his fault and he's just following orders, he was not nice or professional. He literally saw me at the door one time and drove away while looking at me. Secondly, we don't even know if he was actually fired. I might be wrong, but I think here the regular mail carriers are considered public employees, which means they rarely get fired, just transferred to a different job. Next one is titled, Revenge Without Lifting a Finger. Years ago, I had to deal with a slimy excuse of a supervisor, Josh. Josh loved to sexually harass women. He had a tendency if you rejected him for a date, as I had done, he would treat you rather badly and left tasks unfinished. He had managed to get himself fired, however it was not for his treatment of women, it was for a safety violation. Later, he got me fired from my previous position at the same company for reasons that were illegal in matter, but were not related to me. My current supervisor at the time, who hated Josh, promised to tell any prospective employer that I had been laid off, not fired. A kindness that landed me a job at a knife shop in the mall where the following story takes place. Fast forward a few months after I got hired. One slow night, I was standing at the entrance to the store talking with one of my regulars when to my surprise, I saw my ex-supervisor, Josh, going from store to store where women are on shift. When he came back out of the clothing store across the hall from me, he saw me standing in front of my shop and decided I was next. I could immediately tell he didn't recognize me as he walked into the hall and was making a beeline for me. It was then an idea formed in my mind. A sweet revenge. Giggling happily with a wicked smile on my face, I beckoned the regular to follow me back to the register. "Watch this," I said, hiding behind the humidor on the counter. He was confused, but did as he was told, taking up position by the humidor near where I was standing. As expected, a few moments later, in comes my ex-supervisor, a smug, satisfied grin on his face. I waited until he got past the threshold before I slowly sauntered up by the register, folded my arms on the counter in front of me and put my chin on top of my arms. With a very savage grin, I said, "Hello, Josh." He immediately stopped, his gaze slowly going from me to all the swords, knives, and yes, even Gimli's axe hanging on the wall. All the while turning whiter and whiter as he realized 1. Who I was, 2. Where he was, and 3. Obviously what he had done to me flashing through his mind. Finally, he mouthed an, "Oh," turned and walked out. Just as Josh was getting close to the exit doors, I bellowed out from the entrance of my shop, "Goodbye, Josh." Which made him pause awkwardly in mid-stride, shuddering from head to toe, and he stood there for a moment, transfixed with fear, before he walked as fast as he could out the door, not once looking back. My regular and I stood laughing so loudly that one of the ladies at the clothing store across from us came out to see what was going on. In between tearful laughing, I shouted over to her what happened. "I got a thank you" from her. "You're welcome," I shouted back. Josh never came into the mall again. Edit. As incredulous as this story sounds, this event actually happened. It was also recorded by the camera in the store. I really hope that my boss got a laugh after he reviewed the tape. Last one is titled, "Refuse to pay the money you owe? Lose a shoe." This happened earlier this morning. I work in a company where you can lease furniture, and I act as a repo man in a way. There's a customer of ours who is always pretty late and tends to be a huge dick about it, but normally pays. But this time he's egregiously past due and has said he has no intention of paying and basically thinks that, if I don't answer the door, then it's my stuff. Now people who have worked in rent-to-own knows that this isn't exactly rare, but I was told that my pay might be cut because our wages reflect our numbers and this guy has thousands of dollars worth of merchandise. So I'm knocking on his door, and I hear a little movement. I keep knocking, hear a bit more. Eventually, after banging on his door for about 10 minutes, I give up and turn to walk away, but I notice a big stack of shoes on his doorstep. At least 10 pairs just sitting there near his porch's chair. So I look around to see any cameras, witnesses, it's pretty isolated. So I just grab one shoe. I keep it in my truck for half the day, then plop it on the sidewalk halfway across town. I now plan to steal one shoe every time I know he's ignoring me. Thanks for listening.